What is supper? Now we are speaking here about, they're very connected actually, very, but we speak more about, let's say, physical suffering. Yes, they are very connected. If the mind is suffering, the body is suffering. If the body suffers, the mind will suffer. But now more. Okay, what is suffering? Physical suffering, what's that? Yeah, pain. And it's very pleasant.
It's not.
It's not pleasant. You can sometimes not even, you're, you cannot smile to somebody, especially in teeth or something else. It's just very painful. Okay, but we said the suffering, the cause of suffering is sin. But sometimes there are a purpose in this suffering, why God allows this. We will just take it very fast.
Страданието е благословение от Бога.
What?
Има такова страдание. Благословение от Бога.
Yes. Yes. Sometimes actually suffering is a blessing. Why? Okay, the purpose of sickness and suffering
is
why God allows this to happen? To reveal errors in lifestyle. Yes, you think that you are a very normal person, you don't need this, but God is showing you, you should change this one, and that's why you have a headache.
Мислиш, че ти си много умен, но Бог разкрива някои заблуди в начинът на живота.
And sometimes God is allowing suffering so we can wake up and say, oh, I have to change something in my life.
Бог понякога допуска страданията, за да можеш ти да се събудиш, да осъзнаеш, че трябва да направиш промяна за нещо.
Sometimes, actually, you know, Chinese are saying that a smart man is learning from his mistakes. But a wise one,
no, мъдри.
Един хитър човек.
No, умен е умен, е мъдри е мъдър. Наистина си голяма разлика. Умен, кой има много знания, добре? You're right. You just.
Докато мъдрият човек, той учи от грешките на другия.
Yes. But unfortunately, most of us, we are learning from our own mistakes.
Да, но за щастие ние повече учим от собствените си.
Какво?
За собствените си грешки.
Счастие, да? Добре. Защо не мога бръкнати? Yes. But for those who are wise and learning from the mistakes of others, God allows suffering.
За тези, които са мъдри и се учат от грешките на другите, Бог допуска страдания.
Yeah, for example, somebody smoking in family.
Например, в едно семейство някой пуши.
And the young boy that is there, their child, son of that family.
И малото момче, син, дете в семейството.
Ако also think, oh, my dad is smoking, so I also can smoke.
То си мисли, що баща ми пуши, значи
я. He has no problems with this.
Няма проблем да има с това.
And one moment dad is coming home and says, I have cancer.
И в един ден има бащата и казва, че има рак.
So, that child may wake up.
Така че това дете може би ще се събуди.
Let's hope it will not be in our case.
Да, но все пак това надявам да не бъде и нашия случай.
Okay, also, the third one, to learn sympathy for the sick people.
Тоест, второто беше като предупреждение за другите. А третото, да се научим да симпатизираме на болните.
And in the same time we discussed this, I don't remember now when, but we discussed also that God allows sick to be in our community and also
Бог е позволил болните,
poor people,
и бедните да бъдат в нашето общество.
So we can learn from this.
така че ние да може да се учим от тази установка.
Okay, and who read it already, the book Ministry of Healing, knows more about it.
Който е чел достъпите на лекар, знае повече за това.
So winning opportunities. Okay, to learn sympathy for to change now to develop in our character of sympathy.
Да научиш да симпатизираш на болните. Четвъртото е.
So winning opportunity. So winning opportunity.
Да печелиш.
Това е възможност да печелиш души.
Yes, because sometimes people are opening themselves when you are making massage to them.
Ето, когато правиш масаж на хората.
Yeah, they have something or they have a.
Те имат някакво страдание.
Fever something.
Може би Бог е докарал треска да имат или нещо, някаква болест, така че да дойдат пред тебе тези хора.
Okay, thank you. So they have a high fever.
I have a fresca.
Fever? I mean temperature, yeah, is the same? Yeah. Okay. Good. Some a new word for me today in Bulgarian. Okay. And you're helping them with some hydrotherapy for
example.
Yes, and it helps them very effectively.
Това им помага много ефективно.
And just, I forgot to say, how is it possible for you to know this and this?
Как ти възможно ти да, ти как знаеш това, откъде, как можете да си така?
Who knows Rossi and Rossi, извинявам се, Ани and Rossi better, the family, with sleeping sleep, wake up.
Да, кой ще се събуди, кой познава Ани и Rossi?
They know, do you know their story?
Знаете тяхната история?
They start with nutrition.
Започнаха с хранене.
And they are healing people with the help of that Dr. Angel, да?
Доктор Ангел, те лекуват различни хора.
Yes, a simple food.
Просто чрез промяна на диетата.
Yes, and in after that, the people are open to hear more, and they're making Bible lessons and
other things. Открити да получаваме отношение на Библията.
Oh, believe me, if you want to do something for soul winning, God will give you opportunity.
Обярвайте ме, че ако ви имате желание да печелите души, Бог ще ви даде такива възможности.
Okay, spiritual revival.
Петата причина, защо Бог предоставание е духовно съжаление.
I don't know if you had this kind of days in your life when you were very busy overworking there and there and there and you have not so much time to study.
Тази опна за живота си, дни, когато имате толкова работа, заедите с тази сезона, нямате никакво време за Библията.
And one day just wake up and you have fever, you don't feel
и
too well.
И един ден се събуждаш, толкова заемаш теска, болести, страдания.
And you just say, today I'll not go to the work and I have to rest in bed.
И просто ти казваш, днес няма възможност да ходя на работа, ще почивам в леглото си.
And you take the Bible.
И тогава си вземаш Библията.
You start to read.
Четеш нещо.
And yes, and you just see something because God wants to tell you something every day, and you just run.
Защото Бог има всеки да ти каже нещо, а ти тичаш по различни задачи.
And you no, stop.
Най-накрая Бог се принуждава да се спре.
And sometimes that's why we are suffering.
И ето защо ние станаме
понякога. Okay, to learn to trust in God more.
Шестото, да се научим да се доверяваме повече на Бога.
I don't know why God allows actually so much suffering to a friend of mine, a sister from my church.
Знаете защо Бог позволи толкова много страдание да тук?
She's a wife and a mother of two girls.
Тя е съпруга и майка на две момичета.
She had a stroke.
И преживя удар.
And she felt very, very bad. The doctor said she will not survive.
Докторът каза, че няма шанс.
But she said, I want to live. Be alive for my children. They told, okay, you can go. She has some problems already with moving. He said, you can go home and do whatever you want. Praise the Lord for her husband and take care of
her.
But she said, I want to be alive.
But she had this желание to be alive.
And they call pastors. I know if you do this in Bulgaria, to pray and pastors have a special prayer time.
Когато пастора има едно специално време на молитва с
Чуба Богомора, имат ли такова нещо в България? Да.
Но тя беше наистина много заедна.
And they made it.
Направиха помазване.
The husband took the pastor, they had to go back. They were in a hurry to go back, it was late in the night.
Мъжът и закарал пасторите през нощта.
And when she came back in the room, she was standing on her feet and she was walking.
Като се върнал, жената стояла на краката и се разхождала.
And it was impossible, she did all her necessities, she did it in bed, her husband was taking care of her.
Това е било цяло чудо, тъй като тя въобще не можела да става от леглото, но мъжът и трябва да им помага за всичко.
And in that moment she told the secret.
И в този момент тя казала тежка тайна.
When everyone was praying for me and they were making that special I just said.
Аз просто казах.
Said, okay, Lord, I'm ready to die.
Господи, аз съм готова да умра.
I want to do your will.
Искам да върша твоята воля.
Whatever it will be.
Какво значи каква е тя?
And it was the moment when God put peace in her heart.
И това беше момента, когато Бог постави мир в сърцето ми.
And she's alive even today.
И тя дори до ден днешен е жива.
But I would like to pray for her.
Но имам желание да се молите за нея.
Because now she had a stroke after that again.
Защото след това тя отново преживя удар.
But now she has cancer.
Но сега пак има
I don't know why God allows all this in her life. But let God's glory to be seen in this. Because they are humbling themselves and they really are not murmuring on God.
And
if God has to show them something to change in their life, God will give them wisdom.
И ако Бог има цел с това да им покаже нещо, че трябва да променят живота си, те да бъдат мъдри да го разберат.
Okay, the last one is very clear, to reveal God's power.
И последното е много ясно, че тайната Бог някога има цел да разкрие собствената си сила.
Okay, another purpose we have.
Друга цел.
A very important one, to develop character.
Много важна, за развитието на характера.
I'm going to also tell you something. Okay. Here. Why sometimes God is not healing people?
Защо понякога Бог не изцелява хората?
Yes, why he's not healing them?
Защо?
Even they're praying, they're making all the possible
to make. Молят да правят всички промени.
Because people are looking at what they see outside.
Защото хората гледат на външното.
But God is in the heart.
Бог обаче гледа на сърце.
And for example, if it's about a drunk man that's drinking a lot.
Ако един става хода има алкохолик.
Yes, and he has some diseases with his
има проблемане с черния дроб,
and he's praying, God, please, heal me, make me healthy. But God is not doing this. And all his family is praying for this because he's suffering a lot. In the book Ministry of Healing, Ellen G. White says, that if in this kind of case, if when it's, why God allows this person to why God is not healing? Because if he will be healed, he will return again to sin.
Защото ако той бъде изцелен, ще се върне отново към тайната.
Because God sees the heart.
Защото Бог вижда на сърцето на човека.
And sometimes it's better to suffer and to die in the moment that God decides it.
И понякога е по-добре да страдаш и да умреш в момента, в който Бог те е избрал.
Because after that you may change your life not in the right way.
и след това да бъдеш спасен, а не да оздравееш.
It's better to die in the moment that God decides you to die. Let me give you an example. Isaiah, yes? And that king.
Ezekiel.
Yes. God decided you should die now. You're ready for heaven.
No,
please, God, that you
live.
And we know what happened after that. Yes. Two things. He took the people that he never had to take in the temple and showed him. And the second one, almost every Bible commentator says that his son, in history we don't find till the moment that Isaiah came to him that he has a son, something, a child. And a lot of Bible commentators say that
този син, който има Езекия, се отрус след тази случка.
Yes, and we know that his son was the worst king.
Сина му е бил най-лошият цар в Израел.
Yeah. Okay. So to develop the character.
Така, сега да създаваме за другата цел.
If somebody thinks that she is writing of something that she doesn't know, it's not true. Ellen G. White.
Да се развие характера.
If somebody thinks that Ellen G. White or something that she doesn't know, it's not correct.
Ако някой си мисли, че Ellen White пише за неща, които тя на които тя не знае, но бърка.
Because she was suffering from the first grade.
Тъй като Ellen White станаше още първи клас.
And if you study her life, you'll see that she had a lot of pain in her life.
И ако изучаваш живота, ще откриеш, че тя имала много болка.
And especially in the last years when she was living in Australia and after that came back to America. Okay, in one of her devotionals she is writing this. During the past night I had slept but little. I tried to look to Jesus, to place myself in the hands of the great physician. And she was asking actually to be healed in that moment. And he said, my grace is sufficient for you. The grace of Christ leads men to speak the right words under all circumstances.
Христовата благодат кара хората да говорят правилните думи при всякакви обстоятелства.
Yes, and the last sentence is very hard.
И това последното изречение е много трудно, нека кажем,
тежко
да се приеме.
Yes, bodily suffering is no excuse for unchristlike action.
Телесните страдания не са извинения за нехристиянски действия.
Нехристоподобни
действия.
And I'm sorry to tell this, but sometimes when I'm suffering in my body, sometimes I may be not too...
Когато аз имам някои страдания, съжалявам да кажа, че...
I'm not always Christ-like.
Не винаги постъпвам както Христос.
And this is something to think about.